हरे राम शिक्षा गुरु नित्य लीला प्रविष्ट विष्णुपाल शिशु भक्ति वेदांत स्वामी महाराज his whole Guru Parampara. And then my honorable Vaishnava and Vaishnavis, my sons and daughters, I'm feeling so much happy to again return in the holy land, the land of cows, like Vrindavan, or so many pure devotees like goats. Where there are cows, there must be some cowherds, goats. I see you all. Like in Vrindavan, goats and gopis. Everywhere cows, goats and gopis. All the devotees after a long time, perhaps 1 year, some of them were in Vrindavan, but not all. But I'm so happy to be here. I think that we will taste so much Harikatha here and in England also. I'm happy that I'm going to serve Swamiji also, Gaur Govind Maharaj also. I have no caste and creed like anyone. I think we are all in Gaur family. I don't want to divide anybody. Those who are accepting the principles of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Rup Raghunath, Swarup Damodara, Raya Ramananda, the principles of Srila Bhakti Vinod Thakur, Srila Prabhupada, Bhakti Siddhanta, Shruti Goswami Thakur, all are in our family. I want that we all should be collected and we should be the mission of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu or Radha Krishna are not sectarian, are not worshipped by sectarians. So I want that we should not be sectarian, very broad-minded, very humble. Anyone should not tell that Narayan Maharaj and the disciples of Narayan Maharaj or the friends of Narayan Maharaj are sectarian or like they are always quarreling like others. So the first mission of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is Tina Dapi Suni Chana Taro Rapi Sahisuna Amanina Manadena Kirtaniya Sadhar. And then chanting Hare Krishna Hare Krishna Krishna Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama, and propagating all these principles to the whole world that Swamiji has done. So I want to be helped and to help all. I heard sometimes in India that in America, some person think like so, that we are going to be sectarian. But we don't. We should always try to propagate all the missions of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Rupa Raghunath. Following the last words of Sri Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur, he has told last day when he was departing from this world and going to
internal properly.
To serve and Radha and Krishna in Goloka Vrindavan. He told that we should serve Radha Krishna conjugal in the guidance of Asraya Tattva. And who is that Asraya Tattva? Srimati Radhika is the best, the supreme abode. Supreme
shelter,
ashram. Baldev Prabhu may be told, but in all respect, Srimati Radhika is the highest ashram tattva. So in the guidance of our Gurudev, in guidance of Srimati Radhika, Gurudev is Ashraya Tattva. So in the guidance of Ashraya Tattva, we should try to serve Radha Krishna conjugal. And these conjugals in the shape of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, in the guidance of Nitya. So I'm so happy to meet all the devotees whom I have not met for so long time, about 1 year. I think that so many devotees from England, from France, from other parts, they have come here. So we will, from tomorrow, we will try to discuss the Shuddha Bhakti, pure Bhakti, the mission and the object of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. From Chaitanya Chaitamrita, in Srimad Bhagavatam and all other books, also in the guidance of Srila Guru Padma and Srila Bhakti Siddha. Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaj. I also want to give my Shraddha Pushpanjali in the lotus feet of Gaur Govinda Maharaj, who was so bold to preach pure Bani of Srila Prabhupada Rupanudhara. He was so bold. I also want to be bold like him. Swamiji was also so bold. He never compromised from anybody. And no compromise with Asiddhanta. We will be humble, but very strong in Bhakti Siddhanta. No compromise with any
opposite siddhant.
We should try to know, establish truth and to follow very boldly and very strongly and preach it, but not in quarreling mood or in
arrogant.
Very humble but very strong. Like all Acharyas, Rupa Goswami, Jiva Goswami, all the Acharyas. I pray. Young Dasgupta go to speak something, two words. You can come here and stand up.
Shishima Bhaktivedanta Narayana Maharaj. We've been waiting for so long, Maharaj, to come. We're so happy to welcome him. In the West, now this has become an auspicious place. This has become an auspicious place. So we come, some of us, it's been a year since we've seen Maharaj. Some of us since Kartik, returning from Kartik or returning from the tour last year and trying to somehow or other maintain Krishna consciousness and meditate on how Gurudev's lotus feet. Now again, we're welcoming our beloved Gurudev to give us Harikatha and so nice instructions. And give us strength and blessings to that we can serve as lotus feet.
Come, we speak to us.
When Guru comes and begins to speak his Krishna Katha, then the hearts of all the distressed people become very happy because they hear something they have never heard before, especially in a country like this, in a culture like this. The minds are so low and the moods are so distressed and dejected that actually between Sadhguru, Lakshmi Gurudev, and the people here, also the intelligent people, there is an abysmal gulf of darkness, and the light that Sri Guru is carrying here is of such a brightness that I'm afraid that the common people here, they would just blink their eyes constantly and not know what's happening. For me, your appearance here in our midst, dear Sri Guru, is especially to inspire those devotees who have received in the meantime from the lotus mouth of Srila Bhaktivedanta Swami and from the lotus mouth of Srila Shiva Maharaj some idea of how they should listen, how they should listen and how they should open their hearts. And for those who can do so little, especially your coming here, is so wonderful and inspiring that it will keep us going for so many years, hopefully to the end of our lives. I myself feel this inspiration of yours very strongly. This is what I am very dearly like to say to you and welcome you from the bottom of my heart and hope you will be very happy with us and keep good health and also warm. Hare Krishna.
Vrindavan Vilasini.
Amazing. From Biha Bhagavatamrita. They're jeweled. Each class is a jewel. Or even more sweet, as in Vrindavan of flower. So I'll share with you just one little flower, because there were unlimited flowers. He's been speaking about Uddhava glorifying the you can't hear? About Uddhava glorifying the gopis. And he's speaking, Uddhava, as we know, is so high. But Uddhava is calling himself so low in comparison to the gopis. The gopis' love for Krishna is the highest. And he's saying, I'm the most wicked person. And he's saying the gopis, even though it appears that they're breaking all dharma, they're leaving their husbands, they're leaving their children, they're leaving everything. They're going to Krishna in the dead of night, but yet their every activity is the purport of the Vedas. Their every word is the highest truth. And Uddhava is saying, even though I was with the gopis, I had no association. No association. I could not grasp their mood. He only prayed that he would become a blade of grass and get their mercy. He didn't even want to follow in their footsteps. He was afraid to stay in Vrindavan. He thought he might have to cry and be miserable. He didn't want to have to stay. He left Vrindavan. He never came back to Vrindavan. So this Sangha of the gopis is very, very difficult. And the Sangha of a sadhu like this, like Maharaj, like Prabhupada, is very, very difficult to attain. Even though we're right here to actually have their Sangha, what does this mean? So we should pray very deeply to Mahaprabhu, to Nittai, that we can actually take up the Sangha of Maharaj. It's so rare, so rare. It's the greatest thing. And to be able to serve him, to be able to follow him, don't miss this opportunity. Just pray and pray and pray that you can take it up to your heart, the mood that he has.
Yeah.
Also my Khajana, treasurer and cashier also. Also, Gopinath Prabhu, same thing. I'm so much indebted to Gopinath Prabhu and Brajnath Prabhu. So Brajnath Prabhu should speak two words.
Whatever Gurudev has said about me is simply a reflection of his beautiful personality, which we all are so fortunate to be with these coming weeks in Holland, France, and England. We are extremely fortunate. I want to give a little anecdote or story which I want to share with you. Sri Gurudev is speaking in Mathura about the inhabitants of Mathura. They are coming to watch when Krishna and Kamsa has organized a big festival, a wrestling match with Charana Mushtik and Krishna Balaram. So in the audience there is so many Brijabasis who observe this wrestling match, and some of them, they have a particular perception of who is this Krishna. He is the son of Vasudev and Devaki, or he is the son of Yasoda, Nanda Maharaj, or he is a small coward boy, yeah, or he is the beloved of the gopis. So many different perceptions are there. So Sri Gurudev was explaining how some of the Mathura Basis, they had heard from any fruit seller who came from Vrindavan with his fruits. Yeah. They had heard how beautiful this Krishna is, how lovely and how affectionate he is with all the inhabitants of Vrindavan. They became so attracted. They said, these Brijavasis, they are so fortunate to have this kind of relationship with Krishna. We hope that one day we will also be qualified to have this relationship. We want that, yeah, with Krishna. So this was all due to the fruit, voila, the fruit merchant who came from Vrindavan. So now the fruit merchant has come to Holland. A real inhabitant of Vrindavan has come to the Western countries, so far away from Vrindavan. And he has brought so many delicious fruits. If we very carefully listen to the Harikatha, the descriptions, the wonderful lilas that Śrīla Gurudev will share with us, and we understand some little drop or sprinkle, we have some realization, our life is very fortunate. The Siddhantas which are present in these wonderful Harikathas are the most sublime, and they will make us the most fortunate personalities. Yeah. Materially, we will have no more problems, and spiritually, we will be so rich and happy and satisfied. So I pray that many of us may become eager, interested, curious. What is this? What is happening in Vrindavan? Yeah, what are these wonderful relationships that Krishna has in Vrindavan with all his friends, his gopi friends, gopa friends, his father, his mother, and how interesting it must be to visit this Vrindavan, and what to speak if we can spend a little time there and take the dust of Vrindavan, and especially if we can take the association of the inhabitants of Vrindavan, like Śrīla Gurudev. So this coming weeks, please take very nice interest in the Harikatha, and as Gurudev was requesting us, don't worry about anything else. There is nothing more important than this. So on behalf of all the devotees, I'd like to welcome Gurudev to Holy Land again, and I wish that his stay may be very, very, very successful. Go Premanande!
Onto the lotus feet of my Diksha Guru, Śrīla Gaura-Govinda Maharaj. So now, I'd like to offer my respectful obeisances on the lotus feet of Śrīla Gurudev, Śrīla Bhaktivinoda Nāyanāraya. So, the devotees have been speaking very, very nicely. So many points have been covered that I do not really feel that there's so much I can add. But just reiterating the points of Prajnath Prabhu, a very nice example of the fruit seller who is bringing so many nice fruits. So I was just thinking when I arrived last night, because dealing with, I'm not really a manager or an administrator, though I'm in that position, and a lot of headaches that come about, different pressures, and I was being swamped with different pressures, and as soon as I arrived here and meeting the devotees, then I just started to feel, even though it was mentioned that Gurudev is coming, that he's there, immediately somewhere, and I was feeling so much relief just being in the association of devotees. And Prajnath Prabhu, he was mentioning that Gurudev now, he'll start to give so sweet Harikatha, and by hearing this Harikatha, then all these different problems that we tend to see to be problems, then we realize that actually there is no problem, that there's only one thing to do, and that is just to really take this Harikatha and to taste the fruit and the different nectars that Śrīla Gurudev is bringing with him from Vrindavan.
See, Rambijay Prabhu, so much helping Gaur Mission, preaching of Shuddha Bhakti, in all respect. I'm also indebted to him. And his name had been Radha Mohan?
Radha Mohan Prabhu.
I request him to speak. 2 words. As we don't see from front, backbone. Backbone here. But it is the
support
of all body. If there is no backbone,
none can stand up.
So we are pitching here and there. In whole world, but yeah. I know, you should know the backbone is who?
Gopinath Prabhu.
So he's sitting in back.
Prabhu.
All are Nasadiya.
Nirvana
Prabhu. They are my backbone. Hareshwar Prabhu also. All this Prabhu. I request him to speak only 2 words. I know that he always hides himself. But this is a very humble thing, like a pure Vaishnava. So I request Gopinath Prabhu to speak 2 words.
Beautiful voice I hear from Garati Vaish. My only desire is to serve, defeated my guru that I'm at. And I hope to do this for the rest of my life. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
In the evening you can come and yourself, you should take classes. I should rest today. Come tomorrow.
Today, there will be a program in the afternoon. The devotees will speak. Navin Krishna Prabhu, Tapandari Prabhu, Veera Krishna Prabhu. So many have come with us. And there will be some wonderful class this afternoon. Sri Gurudev will rest because of the tiring journey, traveling in the night. But from tomorrow on, he will speak.
What will be the programs?
Who knows the programs?
There will be Mangal Arti. There will be Mangal Arti, his regular program.
All the devotees will stay in this?
Yeah, for two days.
About 6 o'clock.
Because people will come.
In afternoon, at 6 o'clock there will be the lecture. From 5 o'clock your time.
And then after will be prasad for everyone.
After the lecture prasad.
And then Mangalartik in morning will be 6:30 or 6, depends
on the room.
And then regular.
Swamiji was very fond of this peda.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama.
Yeah.
गुरवे गौरचंद्राय राधिकाय तवैवास्मि राधे तम flowers and lambs of cows. That is very well. Certainly it is a good thing. But now some not holy, that kinds of things have been going on now. Slaughtering of cows and other things. But actually it is. I have come here. This is my third
visit
here. I want to help you giving
some outlines of your devotion and love that is up. It will be helpful for both newcomers and also senior Vaishnavas. I think that in the line of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, all are hearing? Oh.
The speaker has to
make any arrangement to hear.
Okay. The microphone is not good for the moment, but.
Okay,
Again. I want to give you a conception of the true devotion that is called pure bhakti. Taught by and practiced by Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself. You know that Krishna is Supreme Personality of Godhead. And he himself, in the shape of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he came to this world. Only 500 years before. At that time, Sant Damodar and Raya Ramananda were very near and dear to Mahaprabhu. And they are supposed to be the disciples of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. In Bhagavad Parampara. You know Bhagavad Parampara? There are two kinds of Guru Paramparas. One is called Bhagavad Parampara and another is called Guru Parampara. From one guru to another disciple,
succession.
Guru gives initiation to his disciple and accepts him in his life. This is called Guru Parampara. Whether he takes the mode, and really he accepts his all kinds of modes and teachings, but it is not sure that he will take. It depends on his qualification. He gives, but he may not take, may take. In Guru Parampara. Like a Guru has so many disciples, Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati or Srila Bhaktivedanta Swami has so many disciples. But I think that only few has taken with their boats. But by
Pancharatrik.
Pancharatri Vidhi Se.
उन्होंने लिया
दे टुक इनिशिएशन बाय मंत्रस पंचरत्न
उसको
फॉर्मल
अनुष्ठानिक
फॉर्मल
एक्सटर्नल फॉर्मल दैट टेकन मंत्र and everything from him. But I know that very few were qualified to take his mode and all things that he received from his Gurudev Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami. And that is why they are giving up and deficiated. Very few are that they have accepted the mode of the, in heart of their so all are disciples, but not qualified and taking. But in Bhagavat Parampara, it may be that he has taken initiation or may not taken initiation outwardly by what? Anusthana?
Formally.
By sacrifice and giving mantra or anything. But they have accepted the whole mood, truly mood. Like Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has not initiated Rupa and Sanatana, but they have accepted whole thing. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu mercifully manifested his everything, mood of gopis and everything in their hearts. We know that Haridas Thakur has never taken any formal initiation for sacrifice and sacred thread from Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Sabdamodara Ramananda has not taken all these formalities from Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, but they have accepted him as a guru, and they have taken all the modes of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So they are in Bhagavad Parampara. Understand what is Bhagavad Parampara? You can tell like Shiksha Guru. Sometimes a Diksha Guru may be Shiksha Guru, sometimes not maybe. Like Jiva Goswami is Shiksha Guru of Narottam Thakur, Shamananda Prabhu and Srinivas. They have not taken initiation from him, but they have taken all the modes of bhajan. So they are more superior than their Diksha Guru. So this is called Bhagavad Parampara, which our Gurudev has told, or our all acharyas have told, that Diksha, this Guru Parampara, Guru, this in Pancharatri Vidhi, in process of Pancharatri, includes in Bhagavat Parampara. Both are one. But those who are not qualified, they should surely follow Pancharatrik Vidhi, taking initiation. And those who have so much strong sanskar,
impression
from birth, previous births, are in this birth. They will not take initiation, this formal things, but they will accept the whole and right heart. This is really Bhagavad. So there should be no confusion. If there is any confusion, then ask. Then you should know that Swarup Damodar and Ramanuj, Raya Ramanand, are in Bhagavat Parampara, disciples of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
After that, Rupa and Sanatan, Arupa and Arunath, are from Saptaman and Raman. Though they have not taken initiation, but more than initiation they have taken. You cannot imagine that how more importance is that thing. To take the mood, this is really initiation. If the Diksha Guru is so much qualified, we can take both things. Only qualified person can take Bhagavata. Then from Rupa Sanatan or Rupa Raghunath, in that line became Krishna Das Kaviraj Goswami Raghunath Das Goswami. And from then, Narottam Thakur. From Narottam Thakur, in that line, also in Diksha Parampara, recently granted, Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur was most important person. In bhakti life. From boyhood, he was very fond of bhakti. And he was born in very well educated and in the house of disciple of Narottam Thakur. He is the fourth guru, acharya, from Narottam Thakur. But we believe that he was in Bhagavat Parampara from Narottam Thakur. In boyhood, he learned Sanskrit in his guru school. And he became a very learned person, learned in Sanskrit. At that time, he was reading also, he was learning Bhakti Goswami Sindhu and all the books of Sundar Rupa Goswami. He is the authority of her. When he was learning all these books and Shastra and Vyakaran also, he wrote three books, Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu Bindu. What is the meaning? Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu Bindu.
A drop from the ocean.
Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu is like an ocean of rasa. And he wrote at that very boyhood when he was learning Sanskrit and all Bhakti Shastra. He wrote Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu Bindu. Bindu means one drop. Also he wrote Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu Bindu, Ujjwal Neen Mani Kiran. Rays of Ujjwal Neen Mani. Rays. Only one ray. And Bhagavatamrit Kana. Kana means
drop.
A piece, small piece, particle.
These three books had been written by, originally, by Rupa Goswami. And he wanted to give a conception, true conception of bhakti. If anyone has not read in three books, he cannot have a real conception of bhakti. I want to give some outlines of Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu. By that, this is like a map talk.
This is scale for measuring our devotion.
This is like a scale by which we can see whether he is pure devotee or not. If some mixture of water and milk is there, how we can know what portion of water has been mixed in the milk? Some barometer or anything. So this is like a barometer. We can judge from this book that whether this person is true devotee or not. Otherwise we can. So we should try to know and to follow. And if we follow this, then we will prove devotee. Then we can know who was Rupa Goswami, who is Rupa Goswami, Raghunath Das Goswami, and their devotion was how, what kind of so high class. Then we can have some greed for this, otherwise. Then we cannot depreciate, we cannot forget, forgive. 1 year, 2 years, and nothing is coming, no money is coming, no praise is coming, and so many problems are here, so we should give up. But if you know and you are entering in this, then I think that you will be so strong in bhakti that you will never be dissatisfied and you cannot give up bhakti life. And that's Krishna mercy will come and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, surely. When Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur was in his father's home, reading all these books, he was very beautiful. And he was married with a beautiful devotee. But he has no attraction. And after some time, in a year or two, he left his home, his wife and everything, and he came to Vrindavan. The Guru told, after 1 year, that I know that you are a qualified person, devotee, but I will initiate you and I will give all these things to you if you will go to home and have permission from your wife. He became sad, but anyhow he returned to his home. He went to his home and to his wife, and whole night he passed with his wife. How he passed? Krishna Katha. Beautiful, attractive. Or Srimad Bhagavatam and other things, the pastimes of Krishna. Whole night. Not drinking water even and not sleeping, nothing doing, nothing. And when sun came in the east, then he begged that I want your permission to go to Vrindavan and to do bhajan. His wife was weeping, but he told that I am giving permission. I am happy that you are so bona fide Vaishnava. And you should not disremember me. You should not forget me. But I want that you should do Krishna bhajan in a high book, high scale. And thus he received the order and returned to Vrindavan. Also one thing. Once he was in Vrindavan, and he was very well qualified in Parkiya Bhava that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu had preached in this world first. But for other person, they cannot accept those who are not qualified. There is two things, Parkiya and Svakiya. Those who have been married by the in the line of Shastra and he has accepted like his wife and she has accepted him like his husband in a Vedic culture way. This is called Svakiya. Krishna has married Rukmini, Satyabhama and all other wives in this way. But he has not merited Srimati Radhika and all others gopis in Vrindavan. But they are more superior than Rukmini Shaktabhama. All gopis, even a maid servant of Srimati Radhika is more superior than Rukmini. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu accepted this line and he preached this line. This is called Bhakti Bhava. Only where there is only love and affection, nothing else. No need of marriage or anything. These are called beloved. So some persons of Ramanuj and other sampradaya sections, they raised this thing that Krishna is not married with gopis, he was married with Rukmini and Saptabhama. So it is illegal to be with Radhika and all gopis to Krishna, for Krishna. And that went to the king in India of Jaipur, where Govind was there, and they convinced him that Radhika was not married with Krishna. So Radhika should not be worshipped because it is illegal. King was in that opinion that time, but he was disciple of Gaudiya Vaishnava in the line of Narottam Thakur. So he told, he invited Gaudiya Vaishnava that you should come and you should try to answer them. And if I am satisfied with that answer, then I will keep Radhika in Govinda temple, otherwise I will keep it separate. Then, at that time, Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur was at the age of more than 80 and he left this world at the age of 100 years. He was so old. So, he told his, he told them that, I cannot leave Vrindavan. I am too old. So, I am sending my disciples. He sent them Baldev Vidyabhushan and his one Krishnadas, or any name?
Krishnadas.
With him, and they went there. And they defeated all the other parties and established that Srimati Radhika was his Hladini Shakti of Krishna. And his Swarup Shakti of Radhika, of Krishna. In Golok Vrindavan, always they are. They cannot be separated, like Shakti and Shaktiman, power and
potency.
Potency. They cannot be separated.
Potent and potency.
Also, this is the clear that when a husband is married with any wife, then wife can give him whole attention and whole prem to her, to his wife, to his husband. But when one child will come, then the her love for husband will be divided into two. If 10 boys are there, then her love will be divided into 11. Not only 11, but love for dogs and cows and everything in the house, for house things, for decorating herself, so many, it will be divided into 100 and 100 parts. But Radhika's prem,
will not be divided, because no son, nothing, no home, nothing. Only Krishna is beloved. So, Gopi's frame is undivided. They don't want anything from them. Only they want to please Krishna and to serve Krishna. And thus Krishna is so much charmed and controlled by them that he can give in his heart on the lotus feet of gopis and especially in the lotus feet of Radha. This is pure love and affection. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has come to sprinkle these things. So, then when they were defeated and Radhika came, then arise any other question that you have no Brahma Sutra Bhashya Vedanta Bhashya.
No commentary
on
Vedanta Sutra.
Vedanta Sutra. Vedanta Sutra has come from originally from Vedas, the more permanent and essence of whole Vedas. That is called Upanishad. They are also called Vedanta. And after that, Vyasadeva has compiled and taken 550
condensed form.
That is called Sutra. If doing bhakti or party or anything, but you are not knowing, you are aware, not aware from all these sutra, there may come trouble. So many troubles and problems. We'll have to know all the basic principles of Vaidhi Bhakti and all Vedanta teachings. If you are not aware, you are not known to all, then all your bhakti can be attained. It will not be
fixed.
Eternal. It helps. It will give some little effect and you can forget and give up. So we'll have to know all these things. At that time, Gaudiya Vaishnava has forgotten these principles of Vedanta. Who is he? Who is Krishna? What is bhakti? What is maya? Illusory maya? From where we have come? Why we want happiness? We don't want suffering. But yet suffering coming. How should we treat this world? If you are not there, knowing all these things from condensed form of Vedanta, then your bhakti will not be strong. So at that time, they were practicing bhakti but forgetting all these principles of Vedanta. Even now, we see some devotees that they want to do bhakti of parakiya, but forgetting all these things. So we should follow first Vaidhi Bhakti. And we should know all these things, principles. Otherwise, we will not be strong in this. And we can give up bhakti at any time. They told that, have you any Brahma Sutra Bhashya? That is commentary on Vedanta. Oh yes, we have. What is that? Oh, we accept Srimad Bhagavata as a commentary of Vedanta. Vyasadeva himself written that I have made Srimad Bhagavatam, Vedanta myself, and I have written commentary, and that commentary is known as Srimad Bhagavatam. So it is natural commentary of Srimad Bhagavatam. They told that we cannot accept this. If Shankar has Bhashya commentary, if Ramanuja has Sri Bhashya, Madhvacharya has Sri Bhashya, there are four Vaishnava Sampradaya. Brahma Sampradaya like Madhvacharya, Sri Sampradaya like Ramanuja, Vishnu Swami in Rudra Sampradaya, and Sanat Sanatan has, and four has commentaries of Vedanta. If you have no commentary, we cannot accept you like a Sampradayic Vaishnava. Oh, yes. Give me time, and they get them for
1 week.
1 day.
1 week day.
He went to Govinda, Govindin in Jaipur, and prayed that I want to make a commentary on Srimad Bhagavatam. So you see, mercifully
manifest
in my heart. And in one night I have heard that in one night Govinda told him that I'm dictating and you should write. Govindiji began to
dictate
in his heart, and his whole life, all words completed. About more than 100 pages. And next day, he gave it to in the council of all Vaishnavas. And when they read it, awfully satisfied, more than that.
Any other comment?
And they accepted. No argument against his comment. Everyone accepted it. And then Srimati Radhika came in the
left side
of Govinda there, and thus Baldev Vibhushan, that is Gaudiya Sampradaya, became victorious there. This was the first thing of Siddha Vishwanatha. He trained Baldev Prabhu. Once he was in Vrindavan. So many Vaishnavas were against him in preaching Parakiya Bhav. Once they tried to
murder him.
Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur, in his young days or old days, daily he used to go in very morning when it was some darkness, about 3-4, and complete his parikrama day of about ten miles. One day he was going, and they conspired
against him.
That today, when he will reach in a kunja, in the shade of very big trees, and where there is more andhakar,
darkness,
they will murder him and fell his body in Jamuna in fire. When he reached there, Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur, remembering the pastimes of Krishna of Gopis and reciting mantra Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna. They wanted to attack him at that time. But they saw a very wonderful thing, that in spite of Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur, there is a very, very beautiful Kishori there with 2 or 3 sakhis. Understand? Her age was about 13 or 12 and a half. So attractive, so beautiful. And she was picking flowers, belly chameli, and laughing, smiling with her 2 sakhis. The opposite persons went to them and told, "Oh Lali, Lali you mean his darling daughter. Oh Lali. We saw that Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur was coming here, but at once he, where he went, you know."
Have you seen him?
The most beautiful Kishori told in a very sweet way, with sweet words, "I seen that Babaji. But where she went, I don't know." Then they told that, "Who are you? we are settings of Srimati Radhika. Where she is? She is now in job. Why you can pick Kanto?
Pick some flowers.
Hmm?
Pick some flowers.
Flowers. And we are doing. And smiling. At once they finished. They sat there. Oh, again Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur is there and chanting and he is going to Parikrama. They fell flat on the lotus feet of Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur. And they realized that he is a very Siddha Mahatma.
Perfect person.
Perfect. And they analyzed. And they told that we are one very ignorant servant of you. Please excuse us. After that, he excused them. And he did parikrama. He has written so many books. He is called Manifestation of Avatar of Rupa Goswami.
Incarnation
of Vishwanath Srila Rupa, because he has written so many books, important. If Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur was not there at that time, then this important thing, the mood of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu may have gone away. So, after Rupa Goswami and all other, what I told, Narottam Thakur, up to Narottam Thakur, a very dark age came. Only Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur have said this. Like Bhaktivinoda Thakur, after Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur and Baladev Vidyabhushan, a dark age came. But Bhakti Vinod Thakur and Srila Prabhupada Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami saved us by that. They gave light and we are saved now. So we should be very careful on these things. If you are going to practice that mode, but be careful for this. You should not acquire Vaidhi Bhakti and all other things and reading the books of Jaiva Dharma and all others. Very, very careful. Some say that we don't need to do archan, we don't need to do tilak or having this tulasi or anything. We are party about. This will ruin. So we should follow. We should be very humble and try to follow Tena Dapi Suni Chena Tarurapi Saishunna Amanina Man Dena Kriti. We should try to follow all these teachings. Very humble, giving praise to others, those who are qualified, don't want your praise. And be Saishunna.
Tolerance.
Like trees. Even anyone cuts the trees, don't they give water, but yet you can go there and they will give you
shade.
Also wood. You can make anything, chair and anything. By their bark, leaves,
fruits,
flowers. Everything, it is for others, not for them. So we should try to be like that. Don't quarrel. Have so much affection for your God brothers and sisters. Even for all those who are